Hi, and welcome to This Is My Architecture. Today I'm gladly joined by Pau from Launchmetrics.
Hello Marina, thanks for having me.
Pau, before we start with everything about the use case related, I would love to learn a little bit more about Launchmetrics.
So in Launchmetrics we build tech and data solutions to help the fashion, luxury and beauty industry inspire more than 1 million customers.
And how is it actually that fashion is really, really related to this use case?
Yeah, we'll talk today about one use case, right? So imagine you are a brand and you are building, you are making products, you're making a shoe or a bag and you're very successful and everybody talks about you. And of course, you need to understand what they say, right?
Of course.
So if when you are a big fashion conglomerate, you are managing hundreds of brands literally and you are selling this, your products in the Middle East, in Asia, in China, in the US. So understanding what's going on, it's not just a tricky technical problem, you really have to nail it. And once you have this knowledge, it allows you to take strategic decisions about your product and your business.
Okay, I see. So now we have a little bit more context of what is this platform, this unique marketing platform, trying to tackle down in relation to business challenges. And for sure, that's being done through a lot of different phases and in progress. So do you mind just guiding us through the whole process?
Yeah, so we have these four different blocks. And the beginning of the journey is in the ingestion, right? So we are getting lots of content, like 8 million post per day, 70 million comments, lots of like half a million celebrities and influencers that are talking about you, and all of this goes into the ingestion. It's content that we have to crawl. In the second phase, we store all of that in Kinesis and SQS. We store the state of all this information in these two services to coordinate the tasks that we are doing with this content.
I see. So the first phase is already covered. Is the third one already the analysis that you're running on top of the whole information that you got?
No. So before going into the analysis, that of course it's the end goal, right? We have to enrich all this information. When I say enrich, we need to know what brands are we talking about, what industries, what sentiment, what are the languages, and a lot of different information that is necessary for the analysis. And we run this we leverage SageMaker with AI models that we built on our own and that are like adding this meta information into the information that we are having from the ingestion phase.
I see. And I can imagine that to run such a platform and with the numbers, the huge numbers that you just mentioned, somehow like handling that amount of data should be a challenge, right?
Yeah, it is. It is a challenge. But when you are using good building blocks, managing big data, it's not so tricky. Once we've done the enrichment, we are leveraging Aurora and OpenSearch, where we stole all of that, right? And this is the founding blocks that allow us to build products for getting the insights that our customers want.
Cool. I'm also curious, actually, I see here that you mentioned and you put here EC2 spot instances. Why is it that you just decided to implement such instances?
Yeah, it was a decision that basically, I think it allows us to save 75% of our operational cost of these two blocks, right? So it's a lot of money that we save.
Absolutely, cost is key here. But at the same time, there's a tricky handling of the interruptions, right? How is it that you handle that specific process?
So this is actually why we are leveraging Kinesis and SQS. So you are building these pieces of these services that are doing the ingestion and doing the enrichment, you need to be sure that if something breaks or terminates in the middle of the operation, you can resume everything and finalize the task that was ended in the middle, right?
That's amazing. And actually, you mentioned about data blocks, and that implies for sure like the whole engineering of the whole architecture as well. Which one would you say actually that it's the main benefit, or which one are the main benefits that you have realized you got after implementing such an architecture?
Yeah, we were coming from on-premise in another life. So now when we are in the cloud, we really increase our innovation pace very much. And also we removed a lot of management like boundaries and difficulties. So that were two big gains from moving to this architecture. Also, when you are envisioning such architecture, whatever complex architecture, having help of the experts from AWS that guide you through using these build blocks, it's really helpful.
Absolutely. Thanks for sharing that. Yeah, for sure, this has been a whole journey, right? Until from the very beginning of the journey until now, this is the architecture that you built. But for sure, the plans are not going to be stopped right now here, right? Do you have any plans to evolve the architecture somehow?
Yeah, the journey never ends. We continue improving our technology. So I think this year we will move the Spot instances, these two phases, into containers using ACS, which is a natural progress for this architecture. And also we will introduce fault ingestion at the beginning of the year to be sure that we are randomly and constantly trying all these services and be sure that the service is reliable enough and fault tolerant.
Perfect. And something that I've seen and that I've heard of a lot is that the world out there think that the fashion industry may not really benefit from technology. But this is the exact, yeah, exactly. This use case is exactly the show. It's showcasing actually how this is possible and how technologies can help the industry. Thanks a lot for guiding us through the whole architecture.
Thanks a lot to you, Marina. It was a pleasure.
And thanks a lot for watching This Is My Architecture.